It's so hot out here where I am in New York City. Like, walk outside and instantly glazed and sweat hot. And it's likely hot where you are too. There's actually record-breaking hot temperatures right now in some parts of the world. But even with this extreme heat we're experiencing this summer, we all know that when winter comes and temperatures drop, some people will take that as a claim that climate change isn't real. Those people are wrong. Those people are talking about the weather, and really, I am too. But what's the difference between weather and climate? Are they linked? Are they even different at all? Differentiating the two can sometimes be confusing, especially because we hear both terms a lot in the news, sometimes without much context, other times in regards to climate change or today's forecast. So let's break it down. What's the difference between climate and weather? For me, it helps to just think about it like this. Climate is what you expect, and weather is what you get. In the case of recent record-breaking temperatures in areas like the Pacific Northwest, or the heatwave I'm in New York City, it can be both climate and weather. It's weather in the sense that I'm feeling the heat as sweat runs down my face. But it's also climate in the sense that these temperatures are not in line with past climate records in the area. But they still mean two different things. The difference between the two is the measure in time. Are we talking about what temperatures we are experiencing today? Then that would be weather. Or are we talking about average patterns in temperatures from previous years that set expectations for today's weather? Then that would be climate. Weather is what you see outside on any given day. Say today is humid and high 90s. Maybe it's 15 degrees and snowing. Or it's 75 degrees with some wind and scattered showers. What you feel when you go outside, that's weather. Climate, on the other hand, is what you expect for a certain season, month, region, etc. It's the average of weather over time and space. So like, if I were to be visiting my hometown of El Paso, Texas in either June or July, I'd expect temperatures to be up in the low hundreds. I know, that's insane. But that's because based on previous years, the average temperature during summer or the climate in that region is that hot. Similarly, in a place like New York City, I can expect summers to be very humid and in the 90s. According to NASA, the average pattern of weather for a particular region is taken over 30 years. Scientists use things like satellites, reservoir levels, and rain data to tell if areas are drier than average. If there's constant changes to the levels summer after summer, then it means the climate in that region is changing. That's why when people say summers are getting hotter or spring temperatures are arriving earlier, they attribute it to climate change. Those things are true, and the attribution is accurate. It's been slowly happening over time. And as we know, climate change is being impacted by human activities, like carbon emissions, cutting down forests, farming livestock, etc. And you can learn more about that with our other NowThis Earth videos, so make sure to subscribe. But to recap, next time someone argues that cold winters means climate change isn't happening, just remind them, climate is what you expect, and weather is what you get.